Ooh. All right, we're here. Train with me, 13. Welcome back. Let's go. Or no, what do I say? Here we go, here we go. That's what I always say on my 60-second reel, so here we go. So here's the deal. We're gonna work on safeties. I did this morning, I did this yesterday, worked on safeties. These are the ones I was working on today. Safeties are super important and we just can work on them and train them, okay? So let's do it. Basically, we're gonna do two different safeties on each of these positions. The first safety I did was kind of, I was trying to open with it because it's kind of a cool safety. It's a kick behind. It either can go in the pocket, like if you were playing and this was on the nine ball or whatever, you got a chance to win if you kick it in. But a lot of times it just misses and comes down to here. So that's kind of the safety I was trying to hit. The other safety is just an easy little chop safety. And there's a percentage thing that goes into it, right? So let me try this safety one more time. Just like the classic me, I missed the first shot that I'm trying to do. So let me see if I can hit it the first time, the next time. So I'm trying to hit it. If I make it, that'd be funny. If I hit one of these rails and come down here, I'm trying to catch the right speed too. So I'm hitting it 10 times, I'm calm, I'm going through my process. I'm trying to check my percentages. I do that 50-80 training. You can go back and watch those videos. But this, I 50-80'd this safety game or shot today and I hit 100 of them this morning. And so it's a thing, right? We gotta practice our safeties and I'll explain why later, but it's important. Other than the obvious, it's important. So let's try it again. We're training, right? This is what I'd be doing if you guys weren't here. So I'll try it again, see if I can hit it right. Okay, much better. Okay, there's the shot we're trying to hit. Now I hit it, yay me, look at this. Okay, now freeze, baby. Okay. This is the shot, that's it. That's what we want, right? So what I did was I hit 10 of them and I checked my percentages. How many times can I kick it and get the ball down here? How many times can I do it out of 10 and not sell out a shot, right? That's not a sellout shot, that's not a sellout shot. If I kicked it and ended up here, I consider that a bad shot, loss of shot. So anyways, that's what I'm doing. I'm checking my percentages. How many times can I do it? You know, I get this ball to come down here about 80%. So that or maybe 60 to 80% depends on how good I hit it, how focused I am, how many times I have. Am I in my series of 10 shots, 20 shots, 30 shots? Like the more shots I shoot, the better I hit it. That's why we train, right? So here's the next one. This is the other one. Now I started with this shot and I was checking out what I liked better, what was more predictable. There's a simple little shot here, what you're gonna see potentially. What can go wrong or right? It's like, yeah, okay. That's a good shot if there's a ball here, right? If you have a couple balls here, we still need to practice that shot, right? Okay, hooked him, look at me, I'm a player. Now, if there's no balls here, and this was the nine ball, okay, let's look at this, because this is what I discovered today. You gotta look at the bank angle. Can this ball be banked in? Not really. It's really hard to pinch. It's a low percentage, more lower percentage bank. If the ball keeps landing in this area, now it can be banked in easy. Let's see if I do it. One-handed, boom. What a weirdo. Okay. Okay, so that illustrates my point. That's like Mike Pancake banking on me the other night. This is why I'm doing this training video too. Pancake, Mike Pankoff. I'm coming after you, bro. I'm training these safeties because that's why you beat me. You killed me on those safeties, okay? So, where was I? I got back into my my match from Sunday night. We have to look at between the safeties when we're training and we're learning and we're saying, okay, is that a good safety if there's no balls there? Or do I think that that bank safety is good? What I realized was, you know, I have some make equity here, right, on the nine ball. Say I'm playing Mike and he leaves me this. Mike banks this in on me all day long, okay? Maybe I don't do it. I gotta at least try it, right? Maybe I can shoot this shot, play the safety, play the nine, the two-way, and try to win the game. Oh, that'd been exciting and fun. That's why I shoot safety sometimes. It's really silly, but like if I was playing, I might shoot that because I got like a little bit of make equity and it's like cut the heart out equity. I like that shot. I would probably shoot that shot over a bank. I'd probably shoot that shot over leaving this thing. If I only had one ball on the table, my life's on the line, I'm shooting that kick shot. So I wanna show you guys these little safeties and how we train and how we analyze and look at percentages. And this is what we do when we're training because we got our learning mind on because we're not all results focused. We're just learning and having fun and thinking about what does a ball do? What does a cue ball do? All that stuff. So yeah, so here's the other safety. That was really cool. I mean, I like that. That's what I worked on this morning. Now here's the next one. I'm here, right? Oh, I forgot to tell you the best part of safeties. This is the biggest takeaway you can have for safeties. And I gotta tell you this, and this is some secret stuff. Absolutely pick the ball or the cue ball. The object ball or cue ball? Object ball or cue ball? When I was playing Pancake, Mike, I shouldn't call him Pancake. I don't even know if he likes that. When I was playing Mike, I was down 8-6. I was hemorrhaging safeties, just spewing off games. And he was running out and he was playing great. And I just kept selling out. And I went in and talked to Brecky. He's doing commentary and he's kind of my coach. And he's a 726 Fargo. And he's like, pick, because I was hitting terrible safeties. And he was just like, pick the cue ball or the object ball. And I knew that from Derby, but I hadn't played a match since Derby. I hadn't played a safety since Derby. I've just been training and shooting balls in. And I remember, and then he told me that, and I'm like, oh yeah, I totally forgot that. And so that's the tip to you guys. When you're training these things, focus on either the cue ball or the object ball. When you focus on both a lot of times go wrong. So that's the takeaway from this video on training. So on that shot, it's all cue ball. I know it's going to stick. I know what's going to happen to the cue ball. It's going to stick. I have to work on the cue ball, the object ball, and I have to work on the speed. I have to work on where it's going to hit on the rail potentially. How do I get behind here? I don't want to go short on it, because when I go short on it, it comes over here. I worked on all that. So good. You guys got it. So here we got a safety and it's all object ball. We want to put this ball to the center here, right? The cue ball can come out here because we're gonna just try when we're starting to hit the one ball correctly. If we worry too much about the cue ball, we're gonna have problems. So we're just trying to smooth the one ball down, not worrying about the cue ball. And we're just hitting a simple shot. See how soft that is, how easy it is? Okay, here we are. It's like, yeah, of course it would be better if the cue was here and here, of course. But I wouldn't trade this cue ball for this ball coming here. You know, that's what happens. That's the trade you make when you split your attention on safeties. So now, but I'm training, right? I'm here, I'm in my element, I'm hitting shots, 100 shots. I have time to work on this. So now what I'm gonna do, now I found my spot to get it here. Who cares about the cue ball? Now I'm gonna add the cue ball in a little bit. And this is what I did today. I added the cue ball in. Can I get it to come here? Speed, spin, thickness of hit. Can I make some adjustments? So let me see if I can do it and what I have and how it works, right? So I gotta make an adjustment. And it's like, okay, now I'm trading the cue ball position for a risk, right? There's a risk there that I learned. This is a fine spot for a safety. It's gonna be great. But the risk was this risk. So I'm like, okay, I see what happened. I hit it too far down here. I had to cut it too much to get the cue ball back. So now I have to say, all right, could I hit this ball again and thicken it up? Meaning hit more of the one ball, hit a little more spin on it. So it's not gonna go so much to that corner pocket. Can I change the speed, spin, thickness variables a little bit? It's like, yeah, I can. Look at that right here. Now we're training, we're learning. I'll take that. I like that cue ball over the other cue ball. I don't mind this ball not being right here. I'm okay with it here because the cue ball is in a really good spot. But this is how we learn, right? Okay, now we're gonna go. Same thing. This here is a kick shot potential, okay? There's times where you wanna hit this. There's times where this will come up. And so we need to practice so we know how to kick behind the ball and play safe. This is just a really important thing. So we look here and we're like, okay, half ball hit. We're gonna try to hit here and put the one ball there. Cue ball's gonna kind of just dribble into this area. We're okay, we don't need to worry about the cue ball. So we do the same shot, but now we're trying the kick shot just for funsies. It's like, okay, what happened? Hit a good shot, that's a good shot. I was a little worried when I hit it because what happened was I hit it a little thin, meaning the cue ball didn't hit as much of it as I wanted, so it kind of came down here, and I'm like, when I hit it, I said to myself, rut-row, that might go right in front of the pocket. Well, I hit it good enough, everything's good, it worked out good. So that's the kick shot. So you have to look at, like, how could it go wrong? How does it go wrong? Okay, you hit it too thick. Oh, that didn't work. I hit it good again. I'm incapable of hitting a bad shot. Just kidding. Okay, let me hit a bad one now. I want to hit just a little bit too thick so I don't make it in the side. Well, that's a perfect example of how it goes wrong. So that's how it goes wrong, right? Say it stopped there, you know, because I hit it too soft, too thin, whatever. Like, there's ways this stuff can go wrong. So we really want to work on hitting it to here and hitting it to here, just being quiet, just being calm, and just learning, right? So that's it. So here's how we train safeties. Here's some good examples of some safeties to train. This kick shot is critical. I'll show you. I was playing Hank the Tank. It was sick. It was so cool. I probably can't recreate it, but I'll try. The whole thing is I can maybe make the 7 and play safe and get shape on the 8 all in one shot. And it's like, you know, really close, and it worked. Basically, I kicked it in, got behind the 8 as a backup play, because that's what I was playing, the cue ball. And I lucked it in the side, and then I made the 8 and 9, and woohoo, wah, I won. So it's just like there's all kinds of little opportunities, but you don't know these opportunities exist if you don't train, if you don't practice, if you don't have your learning mind on, if you're just sitting there thinking, I need to win, 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 and, you know, safeties are stupid. And I'm talking to myself right now, because I hated playing safeties. And I'll tell you, after Mike beat me, it was safeties, okay? Safeties and kicking and a little breaking, but mostly safeties. And I'm like, I hate safeties. But then I came in here and I hit 50, 70 safeties. And I'm like, okay, that was kind of boring, but I learned a lot. And I came in the next day, today, and I hit 100 safeties. And I hit all these shots. And then I stopped whining and I started learning. And it was awesome. And that's what I want to teach you guys. Let's learn this game. Let's play this game. Let's become better players. And let's keep our mind open and let's have fun. And let's just become better pool players, you know? So that's it. See you next time. I love you guys.